In this lesson, you'll be introduced to the topic of solving nonlinear algebraic equations. Here we have a function f that is a function of one variable x. The function has curvature and is nonlinear. In a linear function, the variable is only raised to the first power, which represents a straight line. Some examples of terms that would make an equation nonlinear are x squared, 1 over x, the square root of x, and the log base 10 of x. Many engineering problems involve finding the solution or the root of a nonlinear equation, which is the value of x where the function is equal to 0. For example, here we have a cantilevered beam of length L that is subjected to a uniform load W0. The distance from the point of attachment at the wall to some location on the beam is denoted by the variable x. The beam will undergo bending due to the load. Let's say we want to find the location on the beam where the deflection is 1/2 the maximum deflection. It can be shown that the deflection d as a function of x is given by the equation W0 times L to the fourth power divided by 24 times the modulus of elasticity E times the moment of inertia I times the quantity x over L to the fourth power minus 4 times x over L cubed plus 6 times x over L squared. The maximum deflection, d max, occurs at the far end of the beam where x is equal to L. Plugging in L for x in the deflection equation, we find that d max is equal to W0 times L to the fourth power divided by 8 EI. Since we want to find the location where the deflection is 1/2 the maximum deflection, we divide the deflection equation by d max and set it equal to 0.5. We move the 0.5 to the right side of the equation and note that we now have an equation of the form f of x equals 0. All we have to do is find the value of x that makes this equation true. In this particular case, it is possible to find a solution to the equation analytically, but the math is a bit messy and time-consuming. Many engineering problems will involve nonlinear equations that cannot be solved analytically. This requires us to use a numerical method to approximate the solution. For example, the Colebrook equation is used in fluid mechanics to find a quantity called the friction factor F. It contains the parameters pipe roughness epsilon, pipe diameter d, and the Reynolds number Re. The equation is 1 over the square root of f equals negative 2 times the base 10 logarithm of the pipe roughness over diameter divided by 3.7 plus 2.51 divided by the Reynolds number times the square root of f. We can bring all the terms to the left side of the equation and notice that we have some nonlinear function equal to 0. In this case, the variable in the nonlinear equation is the friction factor f instead of a distance x. Assuming that we know epsilon d and the Reynolds number, we need to find a value of f that will make the left side of the equation equal to 0. Unfortunately, there's no way to solve for the friction factor analytically, so we must develop a numerical method to find it. Sometimes you will have a set of nonlinear equations with multiple variables that need to be solved simultaneously. If the number of equations is small, you may be able to solve the equations by direct substitution, but for many engineering applications, it is not possible to do this. The methods that we will discuss in subsequent lessons assume that there is only one real root. If we have a function of a single variable, having one root means the function crosses the x-axis only once. If we have multiple roots, the function crosses the x-axis multiple times. If there are no roots, the function does not cross the x-axis. And if the function is discontinuous, it is broken into pieces. We will limit ourselves to examining just the first situation on the left.